Oh, and there it is. That's got to be the final blow. And here it comes. There it is. Oh. Super Actor here, and welcome back to Jurassic World Evolution. And last time we ended up finishing up Marta East here, where we ended up basically having to let all the velociraptors that are over here pretty much kill off everything in the entertainment division's mission. And then we had this little troodon, or did I get rid of it? I think I got rid of it. But anyways, I five-starred the island and everything off camera, and I actually went ahead and said screw it, got the herbivore dinosaur pack and the raptor squad pack, because it's like, yeah, it's all I got left. But anyways, I think we're going to continue on our journey here, and I think we're going to move on over into the new section of Dr. Wu's missions, the Isla Tucano Research Facility. So let's head on over there and see what Dr. Wu has waiting for us there. I can only imagine that after seeing what we just went through, it's going to only be even crazier than what we had seen over on Marta East.
This is where I will elevate my research to the next level. Do well for me, and I will remember your contributions and reward you for them.
I'll do my best, Dr. Wu. I will do my best. Even though you are a crazy, sadistic, mad scientist.
So, I suspect that things are happening that I don't know about. Things that should concern me. Good thing I don't much care. However, a favor, if you please. If there's any chance that I could get, you know, eaten, I'd appreciate a heads up before the heads off, okay?
Huh? Yeah, we'll see what we can do. But anyways, whoop. Hang on. What we got?
It's just you and me now. I hope you're ready to start, because I've got work for you.
Alright, so Dr. Henry Wu, he wants me to research the Ankylodocus genome. Alright, well, I guess let's go ahead and get that started, because
yes,
God knows we
good.
Got plenty of stuff for money.
As anticipated. Let's start, shall we? I'll skip the formalities and get right to it. I need you to research a hybrid named Ankylodocus. Create it,
and
then get it out into an enclosure. Once you've done that, we'll move on to the next step. Time is wasting.
A new hybrid, is it? Great! Mm. And I really hope Dr. Wu is going to give us access to these babies. Think of the exposure. Think of the money.
Yeah, well, I'm sure you'll get your hands on them at some point, so before we get started, though, we've got to get some upgrades here going. There we go. Do we got a ranger station? No, we don't. Wow, we only have an ACU center. Okay. What's the exhibit look like? Not much of anything. Doesn't even look like there's even any water inside of it, so that's rather interesting as well. Alright, well, I tell you what, let's go ahead then and put down a bit of water right here in front of this, because I don't know what we're going to need to do for that, but I guess the first thing we're going to have to do is get ourselves a research center up and going, because we actually didn't start with one of those. Actually, what are we looking about in terms of power? Alright. Well, and actually, you know what, we're going to go ahead and get started, bump this success rates up. Wow, really? Eh, well, we can take care of that too. Because that's why I saved up a bunch of extra money. So, found one of those. And a couple of these. There we go. Alright, so we've got to get ourselves a research center and an ACU center up and going. How big is this island that we're looking at here? Okay, not particularly big, so we're gonna have to really watch it. And wow, even the way it's set up is basically the inner base is pretty much set up within a wall, so that's a little bit interesting. So yeah, let's go ahead. In fact, you know what, screw it, let's just go ahead and get rid of these walls. We don't need these. I mean, if I'm honest, this is just going to get in the way, especially since it looks like our most of our growth is up that way. We only need the walls for the actual exhibit. There we go. And now let's try to see if we can get ourselves a research center dropped in. That cleared up some space for sure. Alright. And actually, we got quite a bit of space back here too, so I don't think we want to completely block it off. So maybe something like that. Can get a little further over? Yeah. Try that. That looks good to me. Alright. So, we need to get a path. We just got to figure out which one it is. That looks like it's right. So, we've got that in. And I guess we'll go ahead and put a ranger station in over here. Oh, wow. We didn't have the expedition center. Okay. Well, I guess we'll have to make one of those, too. Anyway, let's do it like this so we can kind of squeeze this in and still have a way to make a path up that way. Alright, so let's run it up like that, I guess. There we go, and plug that in. So let's go in here, get our expedition center, and get it fixed up right here on the path. There we go. That looks good. Now, what else do we got in operations that they're not telling us about that we need? Okay, I think that's pretty much it for now. We've got pretty much everything that we need, but we need to definitely upgrade. Oh, wait. Actually, we need to hop in here and get this going. Okay, that's not going to take very long. Then while we're waiting, we can go ahead and get our ranger station up and going and everything. Let's see here. Get a couple of these. A couple of accuracy. And a reload speed. Yeah, I think we're pretty well set on that. Okay. Create it.
Now this is the progress I expected.
Alright. So, just out of curiosity. Yeah, I guess that makes sense. The Ankylosaurus and the Plodicus. Alright, well, I guess if we're going to make a good one, or make one of these, we might as well make it a good one, right? So, let's just throw on a pattern here. Sure, Coastal works. I'm going to go ahead and put together, you know, something good, and then get it going, and then I'll bring y'all back as soon as it's ready to come out. Alright, y'all, our Ankylodocus is now ready to be released. Let's let it out and take a look at it. First sauropod hybrid. Yeah. There we go. That's a little hard to see because this place is dark, but a lot of the Dr. Wu places seem to be dark in general. Maybe we can get in a better light here in a moment. This is really cool looking, though. Gotta love the design of it.
I'll provide you with a list of dinosaurs that I want introduced into the same enclosure as the Ankylodocus. These are very specific requirements, so please follow them to the letter.
Alright. Yeah. Thing is cool. I really like that. It's kind of one of those things you really got to kind of take a little bit of a time just to kind of really appreciate the designs. But yeah, anyways, we got to get a few more dinosaurs in here. What is he wanting now? We gotta make sure they're all together. Three Brachiosaurus, two Stegomoloch, and a Chunkingosaurus. So I guess let me go ahead and see about getting those together. I do believe the Chung King of Swords and the Stiggy Moloch require more than one, but we might be able to knock that down with some mods to their genome. So that way we can knock their, you know, social level down, so that way they don't need so many. So I'm gonna see about doing this, you all, and then I'll bring you back and we'll see what the next part of this mission is. Alright, y'all, so here is our first Chung Kingosaurus. Throw it in capture mode here. Yeah. You know, one thing I didn't think to do though, before I released this guy was he's gonna need a feeder. So I guess that's one of the things we're gonna have to do really quick is make sure we get ourselves a feeder down for this one, because I only made one actually for the Ankylodocus, or I can't remember what he called it, whatever. Ankylodocus? I have no idea. We'll probably need to raise that up a bit too, because we don't want that getting wasted. But anyways, yeah, let's go ahead, bump this up a bit too. And we need to go in and see about getting ourselves a couple of Stiggy Moloch, which we also have not yet actually made. Now, I have already modified these to where we should only need to make the two, because, well, they got a couple of solitary two on them. And I'll go ahead and make a couple different ones. So, anyways, guys, when it comes time for the Stiggy Moloch to come out, we'll go ahead and bring you back and let you take a look at them for the first time in our playthrough as well. So anyways, y'all, I'll bring you back. Alright, and our Stiggy Molochs are ready. So let's go ahead and take a look at these guys. Yeah. Definitely like the look of them. I mean, they look a lot like a Pachy, though a little bit smaller. But I love the spikes that kind of stick off the back of its head. Ah, so it looks like there is a such thing as daylight on this map. Alright, well, let's go ahead and release the other one. And then we need to get the Brachiosaurs incubating. And once that's ready, we'll see what is next in Dr. Wu's agenda for this mission anyway. And I can only imagine it's not going to be very good, because we've seen what this man wants to do to a lot of the dinosaurs, at least from the last island, so I can only imagine what he's going to want to do on this one. But anyways, I'm going to get some Brachies incubating, and then I'll bring you right back. Alright, and our last Brachy is ready to come on out. So let's let it out and then see what Dr. Wu has planned. Judging by everything that he's got in here, he's got me put in sauropods. He's probably had me put an Indominus Rex in here just to let everything die. Based off of, previous experiences. I'm sure that's part of it. It's somewhere in here. I don't really remember because it's been so long, but I'm sure the Indom's got to be in here somewhere.
Now that we've got a good distribution of animals, I want to get a photographic record of how they interact with one another. Be sure to get me images of the Ankylodocus. Okay.
Who said science couldn't be sexy,
Ankylodocus.
Huh?
Hey, well, how's your water looking? Might be a little while before this guy needs a drink of water, but I guess in the meantime, I guess it can't hurt to hop in a ranger team and drive on over there. Let's see, it's over this way, right? So, might as well just sit in here, wait until the Ankylodocus decides it wants a drink of water. I think about the only thing I really have to majorly worry about is probably that, Chungkingosaurus, I think? I mean, the Stiggy Moloch, I guess, could attack me, but I doubt it. So, I'm gonna wait until it gets a drink of water and see where we go from there. And there we go. Got the picture I needed of the Ankylodocus. And you might notice a Chungkingosaurus that's knocked out right there. Yes, because that asshole decided he was going to attack me just before the Ankylodocus was drinking last time and chased me long enough that I missed my shot. So I was like, you know what? That little asshole gets what he deserves. He gets knocked the fuck out until I get my picture. So why isn't the next part going here? This, I'm kind of confused. Yeah, submit. Why am I not getting a
That should be beautiful.
The next part of the mission? It's twice now. Don't tell me that one has to be up for it.
En route to pick up the asset.
So that's ridiculous. That's not even in there as an option. Oh, you've got to be kidding me. Alright. Well, I guess I'm waiting a little longer. And that should be it, right? There we go. About time. Jesus.
What a cool photo. Did I
okay.
sound sincere? Because that's what I was going for.
Yeah, anyways, yeah, that chunky source was a big
this
asshole.
Is unexpected. I'm receiving reports of an unknown disease afflicting at least one enclosure. It seems the Ankylodocus has been infected. Without a cure, our only option is to move the dinosaur to another of my facilities. We don't have a lot of time. If we've any chance of treating the specimen, you'll need to transport it off-island, and quickly.
Alright, so we gotta take out the Ankylodocus. Got it.
Quest acknowledged.
But yeah, anyways, the Chunkingosaurus was a big asshole, kept on trying to attack me while I was waiting for the Ankylodocus to, well, you know, take a drink of water. So, needless to say, it got a few flares shot in its face for being a giant asshole. And honestly, because it's been such a giant asshole, I might do something just to let it die. Alright, hurry up and go down, and then we can get this thing on out of here. Alright. And loan it. There it is.
Bring the Ankylodocus back. The threat is still real, however, so proceed with caution.
All right, so we're bringing the Ankylodocus back, and we have to research foot and mouth disease.
It's still not enough to bring them back if we can't keep them alive. You'll need to help with the cure. I've put the parameters of what's needed in the files.
Got it.
Transportation complete.
Okay, so as soon as this is done, we can go ahead and see about getting all the dinosaurs taken care of. Now, I'll probably send the ranger teams after the sauropods, because I think that's going to probably be the easiest way to go. While I'll let the ACU go after the smaller dinosaurs. So, shouldn't take long. Less than a minute. And hey, we completed the Nigersaurus genome. And that leaves us only the Dryo left, so let's go ahead, I guess, while we're waiting here really quick, run over here and hit it into the Dryo one more time. There it is.
Alright,
let's do that. Get another one of those, go after that one. I don't want to go after this.
My research dies with it.
And then we'll have the ACU go after these two. And you get it last because you've been the biggest asshole, so... There we go. All out force to take care of the foot and mouth disease outbreak. Yeah, come on. Shouldn't take that long. Wait, did I tell it to tranquil? Oh, crap. No. Don't tranquil. That's not what I want you to do. Medicate him. Ah, crap. Well, one of my ranger teams got destroyed. And, of course, it's by the Chunkingosaurus. Swear to God, I'm going to let one of them kill them. Get you back up. Yeah, of course it is. You know what? Give me this thing. Look, asshole, where you at?
No diseased dinosaur.
Okay, well, never mind. Problem solved. Alright. First mission by Dr. Wu Dunn. Stress inhibitor 2 and then improved lawyers 2.
Well done.
Alright.
The animal is cured. However, this was no random outbreak. Instead, I believe our facility was hit deliberately.
You think?
Which troubles me.
Every single one of them was
hit. You and I should know about the true objectives of this place. And the sabotage, this disease,
okay,
was
dude.
Introduced at the embryo stage.
There you go.
Whoever they are trying to take us down right at the beginning.
What did I miss? Nothing you couldn't handle by the looks of it.
It's mission 2. Yeah.
I need another hybrid, which means you have another opportunity to prove yourself.
All right, the Stegoceratops genome. Let's start it. And of course, that's actually nice to have because the Stegoceratops, as we might remember.
This is my definition of teamwork. I call, you respond. Perfect.
From the
Let
first
me see
one.
If I can guess the dinosaurs Dr. Wu used for this.
I'll just keep on interrupting. But anyways, yeah, the Stegoceratops was our first Battle Royale winner, so yeah, let's go on in here, I guess, and let's see, I'm assuming that's it, yep, let's do it, let's get that going, and can we afford this? Yeah, but barely, probably shouldn't do it, but, oh, heck, never mind, we got those. So, yeah, anyways, we gotta do that, get some money, and I guess we'll see about getting ourselves a Stegoceratops, and you know what? Oh, I so want you to just be killed off because you've been such an asshole. I'm not gonna lie. I got it out for the for that one. Alright. Now we got the Stegoceratops genome. Because that took like no time at all. What's that gonna run? You know what? I think for now we're just going to just go base level because I get a feeling at some point. Knowing Dr. Wu, he's going to have us, like, kill off some of them. So, might as well just keep it basic. So, I'll bring it back when the Stegoceratops is ready to come on out. Alright, our Stegoceratops is ready. So, let's let it on out. Take a look at it. I mean, it's just a basic one, but hey, I mean, the basic one was the winner of our very first Battle Royale. So, I guess not really a big idea to knock it.
Excellent. Just look at this animal, would you?
It needs more than one. Ooh, probably should have looked at that.
Others will admire our work as much as we do.
Hey.
Let's have our personnel observe the Stegoceratops for a bit. They don't need to know any more than what I'm willing to share, which at this point is very little.
We're gonna charge money to see this eventually, right? Asking for a friend.
Guess we gotta get a couple more going because otherwise it's not gonna be happy. So I'm gonna get them going and hopefully it won't be too big of an issue. But anyways, I'll bring you all back. Alright, 5 more seconds to see what's gonna happen. And yeah, these guys are still gonna be cooking for a little bit.
As impressive as this animal is, I think we can push the Stegoceratops even more. Let's create another with further modified genes.
Okay. Well, I guess we gotta cancel one.
Here, but did Dr. Wu just suggest
Sense
your
of at least
first
110.
Attempt at this hybrid was in some way defective? Maybe not. But what if he did?
Hey, well, I guess we gotta bump one up with some really high defense genes, so yes, I'm gonna look through here, try to get one put together, and then I'll bring you back. Alright, well, the comfort level of the first one is really pushing it, but I felt like this one could probably make it before it would actually hit below the threshold. And it appears so let's go ahead and get it out so that way hopefully that balances out before it decides it wants to, you know, break down a wall or something. But yeah, this is the one that has 120 defense, so it's a little higher than what Dr. Wu required.
Beautiful. This animal is just beautiful. Now, let's put it to the test. We'll set up a series of challenges to see how it performs.
All
this
right.
will be invaluable research into understanding our Stegoceratops.
You know what they say about beauty in the eye of the beholder? It's no oil painting, if you ask me.
Alright, so I guess we're gonna have
the Stegoceratops measures up when compared to alpha predators.
Yeah.
I've set up a series of confrontations. Combat most dangerous. Can you keep it alive?
I don't know. Guess we'll find out. I'd known that this part was coming, which I guess I should have predicted. I probably would have taken the extra time to bump its defense even more. Or maybe even its attack, given I had a few extra slots, not many. In getting that, but that's all right. Hopefully this will be enough to complete the mission. Wouldn't imagine that they would set it up to where it would automatically fail, but who knows? I guess it's very well possible. We'll find out as soon as the Ceratosaur arrives. Yeah, and the Ceratosaurus is about to arrive. I get a feeling there's going to be a few innocent bystanders that are probably going to die in this as well, but yeah, I guess you got to crack a few eggs and make an omelet, right? So I guess now it's all a matter of just waiting until this Ceratosaurus here decides he wants to get into a fight with one of our Stegoceratops. Ew, yep. There's one of the eggs for the omelet. Just as I guessed. Well, anyways, I suppose I'll bring you back when we get a Stegoceratops battle against this guy. Well, just thought I'd bring out back to see. Yeah, there goes the second omelet. This Ceratosaurus has no chill, so at this point it's pretty much only got the ability to fight things that actually, well, can fight back. So we'll see what happens here shortly. Oh well, and here we go, it's going up against at least one of our Stegoceratops. It's just not the one that we needed, so that's not good. How's its health looking? Ooh, not good. Makes me wonder what the... Oh! Ooh, is that gonna fail the mission? Somehow I get a feeling that's gonna fail the mission. Yep. That did it. Well, shit.
The Stegoceratops should be capable of winning these fights. And you should be capable of seeing
yeah.
it does so. Get
back and it
in
did.
And get me a different outcome.
Hey, it did. It literally lost to a basic bitch Stegoceratops. It just wasn't the one that you wanted it to lose to, alright? Go fuck yourself. Alright. Well, I guess we're going to have to start this one over again. And I guess this time we're going to have to make sure that... I don't know. I guess we'll have to find a way to, I guess, lower the social or something like that of the other Stegoceratops, because that way we don't have to worry about as many of them being in there and the Ceratosaurus losing to the wrong one. So, yeah. Dr. Wu is a dumbass if he thinks it lost to anything special. It lost to a basic bitch. Alright, so I got both Stegoceratops incubating, and let's go ahead and release the first one. So that way it satisfies the first part. And they're literally exact copies of each other, so... the last time it wasn't in Mission Dinosaur, so I'm not sure if maybe that had to do with it or what. But hopefully this will at least solve the problem to some degree. And I might even end up taking this one and just kind of blocking it off for a little bit.
Just look at this animal.
You know, just until the other Stegoceratops can get into its fight and kill it. Alright, we should be reaching the next part of the mission here again. There we go.
As impressive as this animal is, I think we can push the Stegoceratops even more. Let's create another with further modified genes.
All right. And let's go ahead and release the other one. Here,
but did Dr. Wu just suggest your first attempt at this hybrid was in some way defective? Maybe not. But what if he did?
All right. So hopefully, with both of these being mission dinosaurs, it will be all right. I don't really know. I'm not sure how it's going to work out. Oh, yeah. There we go. Fuck. Let's get in here and get a really good view of the battle. Hey, go ahead. And whack right in the face. Oh, and another blow. Dang, this Stegoceratops has no chill. Oh, three shots in a row. Wow, that wasn't even a battle. This Ceratosaurus didn't even get a shot on it. Wow. Alright.
Now this is exciting. Am I allowed to cheer?
Oh, a Spinosaurus? Okay, that's getting a little bit bigger. And Spinosaurus is in there.
Asset transported.
Yeah, we know. You're a great big old dude. But, we gotta hopefully have you die to this Stegoceratops over here. Okay, looks like they're lining up for the fight pretty quickly. Okay, let's get in here. Alright, yeah. For sure. See how this turns out. Alright. Come on. You got this, baby. Take out that Spino. Oh, yeah. First shot. Wow, actually, you look at that Stegoceratops. It's actually... Ooh, dang. It's actually really big. It's basically about the size of that Spino. Is Spino gonna get a shot in or not? Hell, I guess not. And there goes a Spino. Oh! Wow! Jeez. A giga? Holy crap, dude.
Heading to pick up the asset.
If this doesn't happen here soon, we're going to have to maybe take a break just so we can get the comfort level of this one up. Holy crap, dude. There we go. See how long it takes for these two to get into a battle. It appears not long. So let's go ahead and get it on in here. Oh yeah. There it goes. First shot again. It's gonna be like one of those things where this thing's gonna manage to just like take out all three of them without a single shot to it. Oh, there it goes again. Oh my god. Stegoceratops is just kicking all of them in the literal ass. It's just destroying them all. Oh, and there it is. That's got to be the final blow. And here it comes. There it is. Oh. Dang. That was wicked. Jeez. All right. A whole bunch of new research.
The tusks we created would not have survived, but this animal was queen. We've learned so much about these alpha hybrids. You'll need to be extra vigilant. If word gets out about these animals, they'll be the target of attacks and thieves. Every advancement in science comes at a cost. But seeing what the Stegoceratops is capable of was worth it.
Yeah.
Our first animals wouldn't have survived these face-offs, which makes me think someone continues to work against our
agenda. Serious damage.
The question is, how that someone could interfere with our incubation protocols. We can't afford to let that happen.
Alright.
I'm making you an offer you really shouldn't refuse.
Well, we're gonna hold off on this one for now, guys, because I think that is going to be it for this episode of Jurassic World Evolution. If you like the video, be sure to pounce on that like button. And if you haven't already, join the pipe by subscribing below. Good day, everyone.